Today I'm going to talk to you about something called stance, and that means how you hold your body while you work. So if you look at my body position in relationship to the easel, I'm standing, first of all, and I'm quite a ways back from my canvas. So I'm not like a foot away. There's a couple of feet in between my torso and what I'm painting. So you can see also that I'm holding my brush farther back, that my fingertips are actually touching the blue turquoise of that handle, and I'm making marks from a distance. Now, why is this important? It's so that you can actually assess your work better from a distance away rather than up close, because work that is viewed only from up close often looks different when you step back and look at it from afar. I'm working on a representational painting here, so it's not like the tick marks exactly. However, the method is the same. I want to show you actually purposely on something that looks like an object, something you can identify. So you're seeing me working on a skirt here. It's in the water, and this is how you lay down paint. So you do a couple of flickers. You can twist, you can pull up, you can pull down. It's not repeatedly painting the same spot over and over again. You can lay a couple of strokes down in a row, but you don't want to keep touching the canvas over and over again in one single spot. You also want to keep dipping back into your paint and changing up the hue. Even though I know I'm using only blues, I want to keep changing it up. I look for gradients, and I'm talking in color here, so these are color gradients. The kind of painting that we're doing in this class, and really every kind of painting, demands that you hold the brush towards the back of the handle. Now, because our brush handles are color-coded, that means like either the black band that's on the brush or the turquoise end. And you really want to hold that brush more like you would hold a wand, so towards the back, and you want to get your whole arm into the motion of swishing and getting a stroke. Think about pulling up, sideways, horizontal, curvy. You want to try out all these different patterns, and it's almost like you're a crazy conductor when you paint. Now, when you lay a mark down, that means a stroke onto your surface, your paper, you do want to think about the direction of the stroke and how it's helping to articulate whatever you're trying to paint. So in this case, I'm working on an area of water. By the way, you can imagine an area as being a certain texture and trying to replicate it. But here I am trying to do water, and I'm going kind of at a diagonal stroke, laying down color, but I'll also go down and pull up and sideways. I twist my brush a lot to fit into areas. It would be very simple if I just filled in that one gap, that negative space between the arm and the skirt, with just one flat color, but that would be very boring and not true to life. What you'd end up doing is create a flat shape, and you never want flatness in representational art. That means that you want it to have volume and depth, like what you'd see in the real world. Here's a slightly different point of view so you can actually see what my brush is doing. Remember, when you're dipping into paint, you want to avoid getting paint all the way up into the metal ferrule. You want to only get the bristles in a little bit of the paint, otherwise it's going to be a problem when you go to wash it, or if it starts to dry, it'll create this crispy, hard, impacted bristle. So you just want to make sure you always only dip in a little bit. Look at the direction of the stroke. Look at how I lay the paint down. This is what the tick mark exercise is preparing you for. It's for so that you can move on and actually paint something that's representational, that's real. It is important that your brush strokes radiate some kind of energy to them. If they were boring and super smooth, there would be no sense of movement or life. It would feel very stiff, and it wouldn't feel as flowy. It would feel rigid and set. So we want to kind of replicate the joy of life when we're trying to paint. And that's something I want you to practice here on that tick mark exercise, getting some movement, getting some rhythm, using your wrist to curve, using your whole arm. Again, think of like a conductor or a swordsman. If you're fencing, you're kind of fencing with your surface, which is a paper surface, and trying to get a stroke in. It's important to do short strokes though, so that you can get stuff like a gradient. Here is what the painting example looks like at this moment. I do like to get my eyes slightly out of focus, by the way, when I'm looking at representational image and comparing it to my painting, because I'm assessing for values and making sure that the value's in the right places. So by doing that, I can actually tell that there's some areas that need adjusting, need to go lighter or cooler or warmer.